It's the homecoming of Flower Bakery. Auf der Welt des Mais. Welcome to Bregenz.
Welcome.
Thank you very much. Come on to the middle so people can see. Mr. Snipes, how has it been? Austria 2 days. What are your impressions about
Austria? It's been a wonderful time here. I actually have enjoyed so much seeing this young actress come alive and returning to her home and being embraced by her family and her people and her community. What a great opportunity, what a fantastic event, and I look forward to her doing great things in the future. And congratulations to you. You have a hometown girl who's a movie star.
How would you describe her as an actor? What is her way to be in Hollywood?
She is disciplined. She's beautiful. She's cultured. She's smart and intelligent. And she has a great pedigree of a great mother and a great father who are also great talents. So I think the future is very bright.
That's good. Laura,
I'll be asking her for a job later on.
Wir könnten euch verraten, wie wir echt schwätzen. We're going to do that in English. Strictly keep that.
I was going to speak in German, but you didn't
want Korean. You could do Korean, but then I'm
out. Yeah, we're Italian.
How do they pronounce your name better there in the US? Is it Laura Bilgeri? Is it Laura Bilgeri?
You got it.
Hey, you!
Hey!
That's what I said.
It's Bilgeri.
Laura Bilgeri.
Like Bill and Gary.
Okay, so I'm Gary, you're Bill, that means.
Hi, Gary.
Yeah, hi, Bill.
There's
one morning when you wake up and you know it's the day when I'm shooting with Wesley Snipes. How does that feel?
Shock. And excitement. And just overwhelmed. I remember we met in the makeup trailer. Yeah, this one beautiful day in British Columbia, Canada. And I was not expecting you in the makeup trailer just yet. And I turned around and there he was, and we met, and it was just...
Exchanged mascara.
We exchanged mascara and blush. And
those are
hair products. And we had a great time.
Shooting movies, it's a lot about waiting and sitting in trailers. How does that fascination come to the big screen? Or how would you describe doing a movie? Is that waiting for most of the times?
Always a hurry up and wait scenario. If you don't have patience, you can't be in the movies. And movies in and of themselves are quite magical. So the experience of making a movie is magical. And the fact that you end up with a movie is a miracle. Because so many things can go wrong.
How did that start for you? I mean, it's some years back, but the boy from the Bronx...
That's what everybody
the boy from the Bronx ending up in Bregenz, how did that come?
Hey, you know, you gotta roll with the ocean. You gotta roll with the flow. You gotta go with the flow. You never know where you're going to end up sometimes.
Okay, cool. But now you're writing, you have your novel out?
So yes, it's been about 8 weeks or so on the Amazon number one. It's an urban supernatural thriller titled Town of God. The angelic warrior is having a fight with the demonic hordes to save Earth.
The USA Today is
not a biography.
The USA Today did write, you seem to have as much punch with a keyboard as with your fists. How is it to write a novel?
Harder than making movies.
Yeah.
A lot harder than making movies. Takes more time, takes more discipline, got more people involved. So actually we're on our second version, the second part. The book is a trilogy.
Okay.
So we're writing the second book.
So you keep on writing?
I gotta do something, man. I got kids, man.
Five kids.
I got children.
Actor, producer, writer, what is your favorite?
Dancer.
Dancer? Show us something.
Dancer, just joking.
Laura, living in LA, you live in New York, right? Living in LA must be all glory all day long. Glamorous.
You don't say that.
Glamorous.
It's not true.
Okay, how is it?
At all. Yeah. It's just lots of crazy people, but I love it.
What are the projects you're working on right now? Because what we see is what you have done two summers before, I guess. What are the things you're working on right now?
Well, I had the great pleasure of doing another feature film back in May. We shot that in Kentucky, and I had lots of food. It's Kentucky, you gotta eat. And Kentucky Fried Chicken. Yeah. It was a Lifetime movie, which is a big U.S. Channel, and that's gonna come out in November, actually, pretty soon. So now, and I play the daughter of Rusty Joyner. He's pretty well known in the U.S. He was in movies like Dodgeball, if you've seen that, or Resident Evil.
So things are going well.
Yes, this has been the most amazing year for me. I couldn't be any more happy. And I came back from Vancouver 2 weeks ago and did a show for the CW network called iZombie.
Oh, cool.
And I'm in between aliens and zombies right now, but I like it.
Story of life. What are you up to? You are staying for a few days in Vorarlberg, so what are you going to enjoy?
I'll enjoy as much as I can. Get some sleep. Process. We'll see. Very interesting things. We'll see how it goes.
Okay, so the only thing that's standing between the movie and we are standing in between the movie and now. So we're going to make the stage kind of clear stage. I wish you a very wonderful premiere of The Recall. Wow. Thank you so much for being in Bregenz. Thank you so much for accompanying her. What did she tell you about Austria? That you accompanied her.
Oh, just come.
Yeah.
There's no convincing. He just came. Just come along.
We've been having a great time.
You like the Altenrhein Airport, big airport?
Beautiful.
Thank you so much for being here. This is your.